Hi guys, and welcome to our next installment in our hormonal playlist. And the big news flash today is that testosterone is very important for women. Girls need it too. So we did talk a lot about men and testosterone deficiency. And what might not be common knowledge is that many women also suffer with testosterone deficiency. The interesting thing is that it's an important part of the hormonal makeup of a woman. They produce about 10% of what a man produces, and it's produced in a slightly different way. Obviously, women don't have testicles, but they do have ovaries, and a quarter of their testosterone is made in the ovaries, a quarter is made in the adrenal glands, and half is made in their fat and skin. Most of the women come into our clinic, their principal complaint is that they have no sex drive or very, very much a lowered libido. Some women also have difficulty with reaching orgasm. Also, testosterone has a big impact on social behaviour. So women don't really feel like going out and meeting friends or making new ones or you know, meeting new partners. They're the common symptoms that women report. They cannot maintain a decent body fat composition. They might be working out, you know, several times a week. They might be doing resistance training, but they're still not shifting as much fat as they want to. So it's a very important distinction that we're not trying to lose weight, but we're definitely trying to minimize fat, particularly visceral fat, which is not something that you necessarily see so easily. It's the fat that's surrounding the organs. And testosterone has a huge impact on burning that type of fat.
Okay, so you just mentioned that testosterone has a huge impact on sexual function for women.
Yeah.
How does that work?
Not to be too simplistic about it, but if you think about men, there's sort of this peak and a trough. You know, there's this excitation when it comes to sexual behaviour, and then the sex act happens, there's ejaculation, and then there's a refractory period where, you know, the man just isn't interested in sex. Women are way more complex. There's almost like a big circle, a circular sort of pattern into sexual behaviour. And there's various triggers, there's various sort of behaviours that impact on female sexual health and being aroused. And there's the emotional side of it, there's also the below belt, you know, not to be rude, but the arousal of the genitals that plays a big part in sexual function. Now, there's so many different factors and things impacting on this cycle that you can't just boil it down into one variable, but testosterone is underpinning many of them. So once you correct or once you optimize testosterone levels, women, sexual function is often greatly improved.
How does that occur?
There's two main mechanisms. Sometimes it just might be that genetically you don't produce much testosterone, even in youth. And just like in men, you know, as we get older, some of our glands start to pack up a little bit, some of our cells are not quite so efficient at producing the hormones. So there's age-related decline of testosterone. The other big mechanism of testosterone deficiency in women is actually the contraceptive pill.
Mm.
So the mechanism of that is really interesting. So contraceptive pills are generally either a synthetic progesterone, which is known as a progestin, or a synthetic estrogen. And many of the contraceptive pills have the synthetic estrogen in them. And what that does, it drives up that important protein called sex hormone binding globulin. And that actually binds up all the testosterone that the woman has. And then they have this functional testosterone deficiency. So they might have plenty of testosterone rattling about, but they just don't have any bioavailable testosterone to do its job. So we talked about SHBG before, sex hormone binding globulin. It's like a bus that ferries kids from one school to the next. If you've got too many of these buses around, you don't have enough children to play football. The very, very interesting thing about the contraceptive pill is that even if you've been taking it for a few years, it can actually permanently increase your levels of SHBG. So that is basically putting a woman in a permanent low testosterone state. Even if you've just been taking the contraceptive pill for a few years and then you stop. But nothing's black and white. The contraceptive pill, particularly if it's taken in a young woman for 1 or 2 years, it has proven protective effects against uterine and ovarian cancer as well. So it's not all bad.
So can you give us a big old long list of all the benefits of taking testosterone in women?
Okay, I mean, to summarise, testosterone optimises female sexual health and sexual desire and libido. Also, it promotes optimal body fat percentage or optimal body composition. And also, like anecdotally and in my experience at the clinic, it makes women feel much more sociable. So it does return your mojo to a certain extent. I mean, these are all short-term life-enhancing benefits, but actually testosterone has much more long-term or far-reaching effects as well. It prevents vaginal atrophy or shrinkage of the vaginal tissues as we get older. It also prevents urinary incontinence. And also it's been proven to promote cardiovascular health. So it prevents heart disease by reducing the thickness of the arterial wall, which can build up over time. The other major benefit of testosterone is that it works in synergy with estrogen. So estrogen is known in women to promote bone health and to prevent osteoporosis. Just as important as the life-enhancing, quality of life, improving effects of testosterone are there and well-documented, there are really evidence-based long-term benefits of taking testosterone as well, if you have a deficiency. Okay, so this is something a little bit different because this isn't always the case that one of us will have had a direct treatment, particularly when it comes to hormonal health. But Sarah, I know you've had your own journey with hormones. Mm. You've even tried testosterone and
Yeah, and you're on it.
What do you think? I mean, what was your...
So I definitely noticed an improvement when I first started taking it. Yeah, hugely. Now I find that I don't have to take it and I don't feel like I need to.
Great. And so where were you and where sort of where are you now? I mean, what were the things that you were facing or the problems you were experiencing?
Yeah, back then, I mean, this is all linked up with the thyroid issue though as well. So back then, you know, I was exercising a lot, couldn't lose any weight, you know, not much was really happening for me, nothing was shifting. And then when I started taking all the different hormones, some of which were thyroid hormones, but some testosterone as well, that's when I started to notice a difference. We have a picture, would you like to see?
Sure.
Ding ding. So yeah, I kind of feel like I went from, so you're picking me up at 8 to... Don't bother coming round at 8. I'm going out with Elon.
How is that going, by the way? Has there been a proposal?
No, I mean, he hasn't messaged me or anything.
Oh.
Yeah. I don't know why.
It's in the process.
Yeah, I think so. I think he's just a bit too, like, taken up with his new baby at the moment.
He's probably shy.
Yeah. Shy. Yeah, actually, I've noticed that more recently I don't need to take it.
Yeah. So you've optimised loads of things. You've optimised your thyroid, you've optimised your body composition, you're working out generally, you're eating a lot better, you're seeing the nutritionist as well. So all of those things combined are actually having that beneficial effect on your testosterone. Just to point out, in particular though, your thyroid is almost like a conductor. If you're talking about hormones being as part of a symphony, you've got estrogen, progesterone, melatonin, cortisol, all of these different hormones working together to make a combined effort to produce your health, the thyroid gland is almost like a conductor sitting in the middle, and it's making sure that all the hormones are working together properly and synergistically. So now that your thyroid hormone is optimized, that I think has had the knock-on effect of improving your testosterone levels as well. And that's actually been shown in our recent test, which we did for you, which is the dried urine test for comprehensive hormones, and that actually showed that you've had a natural rise in your natural testosterone production. Okay guys, hope you enjoyed this video. Next week we're talking about hair, so make sure you join us. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and we'll be seeing you soon. Bye!